What's happening, folks? This is Sean from Southside Fly Fishing. Welcome back to the Angling Scotland channel and to another fly tying tutorial. The fly that I'm going to be tying for you today is this. It's my version of the Jingler, a classic Scottish dry fly pattern. It's a fly that has done incredibly well for me over the last few years. Any of you who follow my channel will know that the first day of the season, I went out onto my local river, the White Cart Water in the south of Glasgow, and was able to catch five wild brown trout on this fly, including a new personal best Scottish brown trout for me. I fish it just over 3 pounds. So a wee shameless plug, if you want to see how I fish this fly, see this fly in action, then head over to my channel. You'll find a wee link above and below in the description. And I'm sure that once you've seen how effective that fly is, you'll be keen to come back and watch me tie it. The Jingler is a fantastic imitation of some of the larger species of upwing flies that can be so prolific on Scottish rivers early in the season, in the months of March, April, May, and early June. My version is slightly different from the original in as much as I tie it with quite a slender body, for reasons that I'll explain in the video. It's just an incredible fly, an incredibly effective fly, one that benefits from having a really buoyant dry fly hackle in the back, and then these kind of long partridge fibres. This fly uses materials that are freely available. You can buy them in your local tackle shop, but I get my fly tying materials from Funky Fly Tying down in the Scottish Borders, and we'll leave a link to the materials in the description below, so that if you are looking for any of these materials, you can jump onto the Funky website and buy them for yourselves. And another quick shout out is to Ahrex Hooks. Ahrex were kind enough to send me the hooks that I'm tying on today. So without further ado, let's jump into tying the fly itself. Okay, the hook is an Ahrex FW502 hook. That's the dry fly light. And I'm tying this in a size 14. The thread I'm using is just a standard olive thread. So we start just at the eye of the hook, take a couple of wraps down, trim off my waist piece, and then come down until the thread is just about in line with the where the barb of the hook would be if I was using a barbed hook. I'm using a flat thread, so every once in a while it's a good idea, just before you tie in anything important, to give that a nice clockwise spin. Okay, the tail is 4 or 5 Coq de Leon fibres. This is a speckled cream colour. And I mean, you don't have to be precise by any means. I know some people will be very pedantic about the amount of Coq de Leon they use, trying to match the number of tails that the fly that they're imitating has. I don't think that's at all necessary, so I'm looking for about, I don't know, 5 probably, 5 fibres. The length should be the length of the hook. And I'm just going to come in with a couple of securing wraps, try and keep the waist on the top, it doesn't matter too much if it splays around the hook. Come back up to the point where we're going to be tying in our hackles. We want to leave quite a decent gap because we've got 2 hackles on this fly, so don't go too close to the eye, and then trim away these waist ends, and then what I'll do, just holding the Coq de Leon feathers up and out of the way, we'll come in and a wrap just underneath, pull this nice and tight, and what that should do is encourage these just ever so slightly to flare out a wee bit. Okay, now I'm going to tie in the body, and this is where my version of the fly is a little bit different from the original. I like to use pheasant tail. In this case, I'm using a pheasant tail that's been dyed yellow, and the reason I like pheasant tail is because you end up with quite a slender body. The original uses a dubbed body, which to me leads to quite a rough fly. The final product is quite a rough looking wee fly. And that's great when the fish are up in the rough water feeding on, you know, March browns or feeding on large dark olives early season. But the fish, in my experience, they also feed on these same insects, you know, in the bubble lines and even right down into the tail of the pool. So I like to have a fly which is a little bit more versatile, and I believe that by tying in a pheasant tail body, I've got just that, a fly which can be used, you know, not just to imitate a whole range of different insects, but a fly that will catch trout regardless of where in the pool they happen to be feeding. So I'm trimming off, I think I've got probably five fibres here, which is just about perfect. I'll trim these to line them up. I come in with a turn and then tighten up and work forward. And then begin wrapping up your body. This point here, and then just cross the thread over, trying not to knock your camera. A couple of turns in the back, a couple of turns in the front, and then just as close as you can, come in and snip off these waist ends. Okay, just for an extra wee bit of security here, I'm going to take my olive thread and I'm going to take some very wide wraps over the pheasant tail. So that's three, and then come back with another three back to here. And what that does is it's doing a number of different things. One, obviously it's helping to secure the pheasant tail, it's adding a very slight wee bit of segmentation, and it's also just helping the olive colour to come through. Now, if you're tying a March brown imitation, maybe instead of the yellow pheasant tail like I've got here, you might want to just tie in, this is a fiery brown pheasant tail, and maybe you're going to use, you know, an orange or a fiery brown thread, and that'll have the exact same effect. Now, ready to tie in the first of my hackles, which is a red game coloured cock hackle. This is a Metz bronze grade cape, and I'm looking for a feather which has a fibre length which is roughly the same, if not a little bit longer, than the gap between the shank and the point of the hook, the gape of the hook. So when I pull these out and measure them, slightly longer, but that's absolutely no problem at all. Now I'm just going to bare some of the stem so that I can have a clean point to tie in. That's the good side of the feather, that's the back side of the feather, so I'm going to tie it in with the back side of the feather facing towards me. Okay, you see I've done a good few wraps in there, taking this all the way down to the eye of the hook. And then I'm going to come back just a couple of turns, maybe halfway. So that's helping me to secure in my hackle, but also leaving me just enough space to tie in the partridge. Now, start to wrap forward. Again, these, for some reason, these feathers just want to spin and splay on me. I don't know, I haven't had this with other capes recently, so I think it might just be one of the quirks of this cape. But if you just keep going, you'll find that the hackles more or less sort themselves out. So I think I've done five or six turns there, across my thread, and then I want to pull everything back to make sure there aren't too many fibres going forward, and do a nice locking turn in there. And then same again, I just want to crisscross the leftover bit of hackle stem. Pull everything back. And then it should just be a case of keeping the thread nice and tight. It's not wanting to break. So anyway, I'll just come in and trim this off. And now it is important that you have a clean base to tie your partridge on, and you don't want any of the cock hackle poking forward if you can avoid it. So at the moment this looks a bit like a wet fly, but don't worry about it, we'll sort it at the end. And then the front hackle here, or the legs depending on how you want to think about it, is a partridge feather. This is a nice grey partridge feather. And I'm looking for a fibre that's approximately the same length as the length of the hook. You can go a little bit longer, but what you don't want to do is over hackle. So I'm going to pull away everything I don't need. Just gonna pull forward. You know, that's probably slightly too much, but it doesn't really matter. I'll only use what I need. And then I'm just gonna take this tip of the feather forward and snip it off. Just give me a nice secure tying point for the feather. Okay, now I've got my hackle pliers here, and I'm just looking for it's like one and a half full turns. Once that's secured, you can let go. Just gonna rotate the vise so that I can see what I'm doing. Sure, that's nice and secure. Again, just for good luck, because this is a flat thread, just gonna spin the bobbin. Two or three turns, whip finish. Sure, that's well seated. Trim that away. And then, my gosh, what a mess. How is this ever going to float, you might think? Well, all we do is take a Velcro brush, just a bit of Velcro that I've attached to the end of a lollipop stick, and then brush everything forward. Separate out those partridge fibres and try and get the hackle to sit forward as much as possible. Now, I've maybe been a bit overzealous with the partridge, but that's not a problem at all. And that is the classic Scottish dry fly, the Jingler. And now it looks, you know, it looks like such a mess, but it works incredibly well because you have all of the buoyancy that comes from the cock hackle, plus you have these legs, and when these legs get wet, they just kind of collapse and splay out. And what that does when the fish are looking at the fly from below, it gives us incredible impression on the water. It's quite a noisy fly, I would say, on the surface of the water. And so it's definitely going to get the fish's attention. You know, it might look like a crippled adult, or it might look like an adult that's still, you know, kind of just at the last stages of kind of emergence onto the water. And since I made this slight variation of it, tying in a pheasant tail body rather than a dubbed body, I have to say the fly has caught me more fish than it ever did. So, as I said, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Tie up a few, fish them confidently early in the season, and catch lots and lots of fish with them.